I have written this variable. Okay, so just can anyone just tell me where this variable is actually available with respect to memory allocation? Yes, this particular memory variable or this particular instance or local variable is available by default inside the stack memory. Okay, so why this particular variable is available inside the stack memory? Yes, because initially we have declared that this particular variable is of integer type, and this particular variable is going to store the value at this location is of integer type. Then what is in by dynamic memory allocation? Yes, can anyone just tell me? If suppose in case of any programming language, we are not sure about how much kind of memory is required to execute that particular program, or initially we are not aware about that we require the 2 bytes, we require the 4 bytes or 8 bytes or 10 bytes. So in that case we are using this kind of allocation, dynamic memory allocation. So when we are using this kind of allocation, dynamic memory allocation, so in that case programming language is going to store this kind of data on heap. So heap is again one kind of memory or storage device which is available inside the computer computer, and inside that heap whatever be the dynamically data generated during the programming, that particular data is by default available. So just can anyone just tell me, is there any example which data structures or which programming structures we are using to create the dynamic memory allocation? Yes, can anyone? Yes, for dynamic memory allocation, just like we are using linked list. Yes, this is again one kind of case in which we are using the dynamic memory allocation. Okay, just can anyone just tell me what is the difference between the array and this linked list? Okay, what is meant by array? Before that, array versus linked list. What is meant by array?
Collection of similar type of elements.
Array is nothing but collection of similar type of data. Okay, similar type of data. So when you are going to create that particular array, initially you have to declare the size of that array, am I right? Means for example, you are going to declare the array like a of 10. Yes, a of 10 means what? Or before that we will declare the type itself. So what is in by this declaration? Integer a of 10 means this particular a is nothing but the name of that particular array, and this particular array is going to store the 10 different blocks which is of integer type. And if suppose our runtime you want one more element or one more block to store that element, is this possible with respect to this type of declaration? Yes, means you have already stored 10 different elements, means up to from you have already stored elements from 1 to 10 inside that array, and runtime you want to store 11th element. Is this possible with respect to this array declaration during runtime? You got my question?
No sir, it is not possible.
Means you got the question. Means we have 10 different blocks, and we have used all these 10 different blocks to store 10 different elements, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 up to 10. And during runtime, suppose 11th entity which we want to store inside that array is not possible because the size of that array is limited. Means we have already initialized the size of that array is 10. So for that 11th element, it is not possible. So this is related with stack memory, because when we are going to initialize that particular variable, we have already declared that that particular element is going to store only 10 different elements. Okay, but with respect to dynamic memory allocation, during runtime, we are going to increase the memory size. So for example, with respect to this linked list. So in this case of linked list, we are going to create the nodes, and that particular node is nothing but single block. So when you are going to create that particular linked list, that particular new method or the method which is required to create that, or which is required to find the free slot, is going to create a first single node, and that particular single node is going to store that particular element. Suppose initially we have created that blank linked list, and suppose during runtime you want to store first element. So by default, new keyword is going to identify the free slot, and once that free slot is available, then he is going to allocate that particular free slot with respect to this data. So similarly, suppose you want to store another element, again he is going to identify the free slot, and he is going to store that new element, and so on up to n. So for that particular purpose, we are using dynamic memory allocation. Okay, so in case of dynamic memory allocation, no need to initialize initially the size of that particular list. Okay, so in case of linked list, I will just show you the structure, because in case of FSA, you have all the experiments with respect to linked list. So in that linked list, what will happen?
Sir, samajhlo nahi kay mhatlo tumhi.
Okay, I will show you with the help of this diagram. Okay, linked list is nothing but this is a single block. Okay, and inside that single block, runtime, you want to store this one element. Okay, and when you are going to store this particular one element during runtime, what will happen? How this particular one is stored inside the memory is, with respect to array, initially all the 10 elements or all the 10 different blocks are available with you. Is this clear? Okay, this is with respect to array. Okay, first, this is first block, second block, third block, fourth block, and so on up to 10th block. Is this clear with respect to array?
Yes, sir.
Yes.
Okay. The name of this array is nothing but A, and what is the index for this first first block is 0. Then 1 up to 10 means what is the index for last block?
9.
Okay.
9.
So in case of array, when you are going to store some kind of data, okay, here in this case we have been considered as an integer type of data. So initially from the memory, 10 different blocks are directly initialized. Continuous 10 different blocks are directly initialized with respect to this array. Is this clear with respect to array? Okay. Continuous 10 different blocks are directly initialized with respect to this A. Next one, with respect to linked list. Now I am talking about dynamic memory allocation. So in case of dynamic memory allocation, no need to allocate initial memory. Okay. This is the first point. Clear? No need to allocate directly memory. So during runtime, if block is, or if you want some memory to store that data, in that case, just create or just identify free slot and store that data runtime. So in case of linked list, so this is the representation with respect to this, and this particular linked list is nothing but node, and this particular node contains two different parameters. First field is called as data. Okay, means every node is divided into two different part. First one is called as data, and second one is called as pointer. Okay, is this visible? Data and pointer, whatever. Okay, I'm talking about linked list. So this is nothing but structure with respect to linked list. And linked list is nothing but single node. So node is basically made up of with the help of two different fields. First field is called as data field, and second field is called as pointer, or in another word we called as a next. Is this visible?
Yes sir.
Guys, okay, so now I will just tell you, and this particular whole part is called as node with respect to linked list. And suppose with respect to array, we have stored all the 10 different elements, okay, inside the array, and that particular array is called as a of 10 initially. Okay, suppose with respect to linked list, you have to store all these 10 different elements. So how many nodes are created during runtime? Yes, how many nodes are required to store all these 10 different elements? So 10 different nodes are required to store all these 10 different elements. Okay, so inside the single node, only one element is stored. And this particular node is stored inside the free memory slot. So the size required to store this particular node is available inside the heap memory. Okay, means he is directly identified the free slot, and he is directly going to store that particular element inside that particular slot. So this is the structure. So this is called as first element, which is available inside the array, and this particular pointer. Then what is meant by that pointer? What data is available inside that pointer? Yes, can anyone just tell me?
Address to the next node.
Address of the next node. Suppose we already discussed about that. To store all these 10 elements, 10 different nodes are directly generated. I will draw a few nodes with respect to their addresses. So I will just write here address of the first node is 100. And assume that this is the address of second node 200. This is the address of third node 300. And this is the address of fourth node 400. So what will happen, guys? Suppose this is nothing but single node, and single node. Yes, what will happen? Inside the first one, in this case, one, he will directly point to the second node where the second data is available. Okay, and inside the second node, inside the first field data, which data is available? 2 is the data which is available inside the second node, and he is going to point to the third node. So this is the representation with respect to linked list. So dynamically the node is created as per the requirement where the free slot is available, and by default that pointer or next variable is going to directly point that next node. Is this clear? Little bit. Yes, concept with respect to linked list.
Yes, sir.
How dynamic memory is allocated?
Yes,
sir. Sir, jo last node asnar na, tyacha tela reference konach asnar?
That is nothing but null or empty. Null or empty. Okay. And when you are going to create the another node, runtime, during runtime, suppose assume that this one is nothing but the last node. Which with respect to this array, assume that this is 1000. Okay, and I will erase this one null, and inside that I will just write down 1000. Okay, for our assumption, and your question is that okay, here null is available with respect to our data. What will happen if suppose we want to store one more data, means 11th is nothing but the data which we want to store. So in that case, again your compiler is going to create one more node as per the memory allocation. Suppose assume that this particular node is created at 2000 memory location, and inside that you are going to store that particular data is nothing but 11. And now what will happen with respect to this null? Inside that null is going to point to that particular location. Is this clear? And what is the next pointer with respect to new node? Is again null. Okay, clear?
Oh, sir.
Yes, guys, clear?
Yes,
how actually nodes are created or dynamically generated. Okay, again, one more. With respect to this dynamic memory allocation or with respect to this linked list, you can insert node in between two nodes. Means you are, suppose you want to insert one more node in between or inside the third position. So in that case, again, you will manage that with respect to pointer field. Okay, so with respect to this one, so now we are directly moving towards how we are going to create that particular dynamic memory. So for that case, okay, so look at the last sentence. Many times we are not aware in advance how much memory we will need to store particular information, okay, in a defined variable, and the size of required memory can be determined at runtime. So in that case, we require the dynamic memory allocation. So in that case, we are using that linked list. Yes, can anyone just tell me what is the example with respect to dynamic memory allocation? Yes, and with respect to array. Real-time example where we can map these different data structures. Yes, array. Array is used to store the student information. For example, with respect to our class, what is the strength of our class? Yes, guys. Assume that it is 60. Clear? Because initially we know the strength of our class. Is this clear? So in that case, we are using array to store all the information with respect to student or with respect to that class. Yes. So similarly, can anyone just tell me example with respect to dynamic memory allocation where we cannot define the length of that particular data? Yes. An example, guys, real time example. Yes, guys. Okay, in case of admission, okay, when you are going to fill the form or the first round for option form, in that case, by default, number of students directly admitted with respect to first round. Again, suppose they want to admit, they directly freeze their admission. Some of them are want to again try for second round. Again, they are going to choose for betterment. So in that case, directly memory is reserved for all the students, again deallocated for this case. Again, one more with respect to, suppose in that case you want to find out, or with respect to reservation, railway reservation, you know how many passengers are in waiting initially, we don't know. Or with respect to movie tickets, we don't know how many clients are there who are going to hire or who are going to purchase that particular ticket. So in that case, dynamic data or dynamic memory allocation is required. Initially, we don't know how many tickets or how many seats are going to be reserved. Okay, so in that case, we are using that dynamic allocation. Okay, so next one, in static memory allocation, decision of memory allocation is done at compile time. More important. So with respect to static memory allocation, decision of memory is done at only compile time. Okay. For example, integer A, we already discussed about that. So during runtime, variables are by default created. And in case of dynamic allocation, both decisions and allocation of memory is done during only execution time. Okay, because suppose with respect to particular movie, that particular movie is released on will be released on Friday, and suppose assume that for first day first show, no tickets are directly reserved. So in that case, no movie is going to or no seat is book, and again another Friday, all the tickets are directly reserved. So this is again during execution time. So that's why in case of dynamic allocation, both the decisions as well as allocation of memory is done during only execution. Okay, so for that particular purpose, in case of C++ language, we are using two different operators. First one is called as new operator and second one is called as delete operator. So new operator is required or is used to create or is used to request the new memory allocation on free storage device. Okay, so this is the use of new. Means suppose you want to create the new block or new memory allocation with respect to heap or with respect to free storage device. So in that case, we are using that new keyword. And the use of the delete operator is that suppose whatever be the memory space which we already allocated and we have to release that particular memory. So in that case, we are using that delete operator. Okay, so there are lots of ways to represent this particular new operator. So I will write few syntax how we are using that new operator in our programming language. First syntax is the we are using pointer variable, then most important the new keyword, and is the data type. So this is the first way in which we are going to represent that particular variable during runtime. So here in this case, pointer variable is the pointer of type that data is. For example, assume that data type is of integer. So pointer variable is again going to point the integer type. So data type could be any built-in data types. For example, integer, float, character, including array also. Okay, so I will write example with respect to this. Yes, so what is the example, guys? How we can represent or how we can allocate the memory with respect to new keyword with respect to this syntax? Yes, guys. Guys, pointer variable. So for that particular purpose, I will use star p. Next one, I will use new keyword as it is. And next, data type means which data type I will consider? Any data type. So assume that integer. So this is the representation in which we are going to create the pointer variable. Okay, so again, one more. Is this valid declaration, guys? Initially, when you are going to create the pointer variable, by default, you have to declare that variable or initialize that variable by some value. You got my question? When you are going to create the pointer variable, at that time, it is mandatory to declare that variable by some other value. Yes, guys, you got my question? When you are going to create any pointer variable, assume that I will write here, when I will create this variable, it is mandatory to declare that variable, declare that variable. So we have to define that variable or initialize that variable initially. Is it required to point with respect to pointer variable? Yes, initialization is required with respect to pointer variable.
No, sir.
So what? Yes, which keyword I will write here? I will write null. So if I am using integer star p is equal to null, and suppose in case of second line, so I will use the new keyword of integer type. So again, this is again one kind of representation. So first line is relatively dynamic representation, integer star p is equal to new integer, and this is the second representation, integer star p is equal to null. Because when you are going to create the pointer variable, so no need to directly initialize that variable, or no need to directly assign any value with respect to pointer variable. But my question is that with respect to reference variable, yes, initialization is required. Yes, guys, what my question? Okay, guys, before that, inside the chat window, just write down your name and roll number, because only 1 minute is left. So we will continue this all this discussion in next session immediately.